Hi, I'm Yihao, and today I will share a project called Slideshow, a system that supports flexible non-visual exploration of presentation videos. People use videos to convey information in courses, conference talks, job training, and more. Unfortunately, people upload these videos without the slides. The videos alone are not accessible to blind and visually impaired viewers because many speakers do not describe their slides. For example, consider watching this TED Talk without seeing the slides.
When I gave up sugar for 30 days, day 31 looked like this.
Here, we miss out when the speaker referenced the large pile of chocolate on his slide. So, what can we do to make these videos accessible? The two options are to create audio descriptions or provide the accessible slides. An audio description provides narration of important visual content, and here is an example.
When I gave up sugar for 30 days, day 31 looked like this.
A large pile of chocolates on the floor.
But the recorded description might leave out visual content. Accessible slides, on the other hand, provide information for all of the visual content, but they are not synchronized to the talk. So when you hear day 31 look like this, you will need to read through all the slides until you find the right one. So, our goal is to make online video accessible through flexible and synchronous access to all slide content. To achieve this goal, we created Slideshow. Slideshow takes a presentation video as input and automatically extracts the slides to make the text and image elements screen reader accessible. Then, Slideshow aligns the speaker's narration to the slide elements to make it easy to access undescribed information on demand. Now, watching a TED Talk with Slideshow, users can easily pause the video to obtain more information about the slide.
When I gave up sugar for 30 days, day 31 looked like this.
Heading level 5, slide 11, undescribed regions. Image, a stack of chocolate scattered on the floor.
Slideshow is powered by several algorithm methods. The first step is to extract slide frames. To do this, we detect shot boundaries, then remove shots that do not contain slides. Some slides include animation, so we only select the last slide frame. Slideshow displays the detected slide boundaries on the video timeline. As the users place the presentation video, Slideshow updates the slide pane to show the current slide number and place an auto notification to let users know that the slide has changed.
When writing an outcome, be clear about what students will need to learn and how you expect them to demonstrate this.
Slide 6.
Effective learning outcomes are what's called SMART.
Slideshow then extracts the text and image elements for each slide. To do this, we extract text elements with optical character recognition and identify image bounding boxes. We obtain a description for each image using Microsoft Scene Detection, and speakers can add the results with edit mode. We group text elements into lists as necessary. Here, a user navigates through a slideshow's extracted elements in a slide pane.
Heading level 5, slide 6, current slide. Title, effective learning outcomes are SMART. List 5 items. Bullet, specific, bullet, measurable, bullet, attainable, bullet, relevant, bullet, time bound, end of list, image, arrow, end of current slide, group.
So far, Slideshow extracts all of the slide elements, but many of these elements are fully redundant with the presenter's speech. To help users identify important moments when there's visual content missing from the speech, Slideshow automatically detects the described and undescribed slide elements. To do this, we first tokenize the speech tags into sentences. For each sentence, we then compute the cosine similarity between the sentence embedding and each slide element embedding. If the element's maximum similarity score passes the threshold of 0.3, it is counted as described and linked to the sentences with highest similarity score. For instance, the slide element effective learning outcomes are smart has a similarity of 0.9. For the speech sentence, effective learning outcomes are what's called smart. So this element is marked described. If the maximum score is below 0.3, then the element is counted as undescribed. For instance, the word attainable was not described in the speech and only has a maximum similarity score of 0.2. Our interface shows the undescribed elements in the elements pane and place an audio notification of the end of each slide that contains undescribed elements. I'll play an example showing the end of a slide, the undescribed element notification, and then user navigating to undescribed content.
Students should be able to accomplish this learning and demonstrate it in the way laid out in the outcome in the time frame available.
Extra content on slide.
Heading level 5, slide 6, undescribed regions. List 1 item, bullet, attainable, end of list, image, arrow, end of undescribed regions of current slide group.
To see how SlideShow would perform in the wild, we evaluated each component against the ground truth labeling of 158 slides from 20 presentation videos. Our slide boundary detection achieved a precision and recall of around 97% as it relied on existing shot detection methods. The image segmentation and text grouping both had precision and recall around 90%. Errors most commonly occur when SlideShow recognized extra image segments. For instance, our method broke a set of icons designed to represent a class into individual images. Finally, our slide element to sentence alignment performed with a precision of 87.4% and a recall of 82.1%. Errors happen most often when presenters' description of their images were not similar to the automatic descriptions. We evaluated SlideShow through a user study with 10 blind and visually impaired participants compared to two versions of SlideShow. SlideShow with just the extracted slide but no synchronization versus the full SlideShow interface with auto notations and synchronized slides. After participants view each slide interface with a different video, they answered two questions about the video content and participated in an interview. Participants answered all questions accurately with both interfaces, but using SlideShow sync mode, they spent significantly less time to achieve the same accuracy. Participants using SlideShow sim mode also view significantly fewer slide elements that were fully redundant with the speech, saving them time and effort. Overall, 8 of the 10 participants ultimately preferred the full SlideShow interface because it provided granular access to the information at the time it was relevant. On the other hand, the 2 participants who preferred the interface without synchronization liked that they could move forward and backwards to the slides as the video played. We thus include this in the final interface. In the future, we will provide flexible non-visual access to information in more types of videos. We will also explore how we can generate audio descriptions for presentation videos specifically. Finally, we encourage authors to release their slides along with their talk. In the future, we could align these slides to the videos rather than extracting them from scratch. With that, I'd like to end my talk, and I'd like to thank my collaborators and mentors, Jeffrey Bigham and Amy Povel. Thank you.